गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. चैप्टर नंबर 5 वाटर अराउंड अस. स्टूडेंट्स, दिस चैप्टर वी हैव डन एंड टुडे वी विल डू रिकैप्चुलेशन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. मेन पॉइंट्स वी विल डिस्कस हियर. सो स्टूडेंट, एज वी ऑल नो, वाटर इज अ बेसिक नेसेसिटी ऑफ लाइफ. विदाउट वाटर वी कैन नॉट लिव. Nobody can live without water. So we need water for drinking, and other activities are also there in which we need water, as cooking, bathing, washing clothes, cleaning, gardening, etc. So many activities are there which without water we cannot do this activity. So students, plants and animal also need water to live. Plants and animal also need water to live. Without water they also cannot live, because plants need water to prepare their food. They prepare their food with the help of water. Animal need water to live and grow, as well as drinking also. So farmer also need water to grow crops. Student, crops are which we use in our daily life to eat, like wheat, maize. We always use these crops in our daily life, and farmers need water to grow these crops, and in many industries also requires the water. Water help in transportation of goods and people by boats, ship, ferries, other means of water transport. So these are the water transport in which water helps in transportation. Students, water is also used to generate electricity also. It requires to generate electricity. Without water, electricity cannot generate. So another thing is, we all enjoy these water sports. Everybody knows about it. In summer season we enjoy this. So water is very important for these activities also. So next is, student, form of water. We read form of water. There are three forms of water. How many forms of water? There are three forms of water. First is liquid, second gas, and third is solid. So these are the three forms of water. Liquid, how liquid? Water is in its liquid form when it is at normal temperature. Means which water we are drinking nowadays, that is in a liquid form. It is colorless and tasteless. So it is without color, only white shade is there. So it is tasteless and colorless, transparent liquid. So this is liquid form of water. Next is gas form of liquid. Students, water changes into gas or water vapor, which I told you, when we heat the water, when it boils and some steam always come out from it, this is called the gas, and that is called evaporation also, I told. Third form of this water is solid. In solid form, when we cool the water and we keep it in the fridge, that ice cubes, we see that ice cube. So in the form of ice cubes is water is solid. So these are the three form of water. Next we are talking about water cycle. First of all, we will come to know what is water cycle. Students, the water on earth moves in a continuous cycle. Water on earth moves in a continuous circle from ocean to air and air to land and back to the ocean. So this is a earth circle. First ocean to air, after that air to land, and then back to the ocean. This is called water cycle. The water cycle, students, the water cycle has three main stages. How many stages? Three main stages. So first stage is evaporation. First stage is evaporation. What is evaporation, students? The changes of liquid. Liquid form is, which I told you, simple colorless water, colorless and tasteless water which we drink. So in that form, when we heated that water and that gas comes out, water vapor comes out, it is and it mixes in the air and it form the clouds. So the evaporation is changing of liquid water into gas. When our water changes into liquid or it changes into gas or water vapor, it is called evaporation. Second is condensation. So students, condensation is changing of water vapor, which water vapor is coming from the heat water into liquid form. When that it comes in liquid form, you can see in this class I told you this example earlier also students, when it convert in a form of liquid, then it cools and this is called condensation. So these were the two main stages, and third one we are talking about precipitation. So student, now precipitation is a term used mainly for rain but also for hail and snow. Precipitation, which I told you, when these evaporate gas which comes to the sky, and they make a thick clouds. When these clouds, you can see in this picture, when these clouds filled with water, then some water comes to the down to the earth in a form of hail, snow or rain. This is called precipitation. So we have made this story also for you student. It will be very easy for you if you will read this story carefully. The water from the sea, it is sea, you can see in this picture, the water from the sea and ocean gets heated by the sun. When sun rises, sunlight comes to this ocean and water bodies, then water heated, and when the water is heated, it evaporates, means it converted into gas. It evaporated and changes into water vapor or gas. Once the water changes into gas, jaise hi change hota hai wo gas mein, it becomes lighter, it's very lighter, and goes up higher in the atmosphere. It goes into the higher in the atmosphere. The temperature at higher altitude is very low. Temperature is very low, so that very cooler place is there. So water vapor cools down and condenses into lot of tiny drop of water. The tiny droplets bump into each other and form clouds. So student, precipitation occurs when the clouds become so full of water. As I told, when these clouds full of water and it's too much heavy to keep that water inside, then they come down in the form of rain, hail and snow. So next is sources of water. Student, yesterday also we have read about it. These are the three sources which we are telling here, source of water. So rain is the main source of water. Rainwater falls in river, lakes, ponds, and when they filled with water, then we collect the water from the rain, ponds, wells, lakes, and we clean it and supply it into the homes. Next source of water is snow. When the snow on the snow-covered mountains melt slowly in the summers, that water flows down the mountain into the river and lakes. So this is also source of water. Next is underground water. Students, when rain comes down, sometimes that water goes underground and it taken out from the well, tube well and hand pumps. With the help of tube wells, hand pumps, we take out the water which is in the underground. So next is making water fit for drinking. How we can make our water fit for drinking? So first we can boil the water. If we will boil the water, then all germs will be killed out. So this is the way to make our water filled. First boiling, second is water filter, and third is aqua guard or RO, which we are using nowadays at our home. So as we know, purify water is very important for us to clean, because if we will drink dirty water, it harms our body, it spoils our body and it make us ill. So we should drink always clean water. So next, rainwater harvesting. Students, rainwater harvesting is a very good idea. When rain comes, sometimes what can you do? You can gather and store that water. You can put anything, you can keep anything like bucket, tub at your home, on your terrace, and you can collect that water and you can use it for gardening, cleaning, washing, etc. Because water is very much precious, student. We should not waste even a single drop of water. We should save water, save life. If water will be saved, automatically our life will be saved. Because without water, we cannot live. So as we, water is very important for our life. So if we will save the water, our life automatically will be saved. So we should save water, save life. Thank you. Have a nice day.